Hello student, good morning to everyone. I hope you all are happy, healthy and fine at home. Do you remember what were we discussing yesterday? I think we were discuss about the syllabus of paper number CBOP 3, that is choice based optional paper 3. The section number 2 we have just started. The what are the point involved in the section 2, or we are going to deal with the section number 2, that is the carbohydrates. Carbohydrate chemistry, as we know that chemistry is a creative science, all about the all science, creative science, and therefore that carbohydrate chemistry today, look at here, we are going to start, or we are going to discuss the basics of carbohydrates. Basics means what are the fundamental thing we are required for study the carbohydrate chemistry. First, where do you find that word carbohydrates? Because if you see this carbohydrate chemistry, or the definition of the carbohydrate chemistry, carbohydrates are polyhydroxy optically active containing CHO means aldehyde, or the ketone group is known as carbohydrate. There are the various definition made by the different scientists, but here just remember, as the carbohydrates are polyhydroxy, poly means many, hydroxy, polyhydroxy optically active, and as we know that optical activity is one of the important physical property of the organic compound, and the instrument used to measure the optical activity is a polarimeter, and the optical activity or the optical isomerism, the certain substance rotate the plane of polarization through certain rotation is known as optical activity. And if what type of the molecule possess or shows optical activity, those are having chiral center or chiral carbon. Chiral carbon means what? What does it mean? Chiral means the carbon atom carries 4 different group, is known as chiral carbon, or we can call it as a chiral center in terms of the organic chemistry. So that chiral, and that if the organic compound having only one chiral center, that compound is definitely, it must be the optically active in nature. But suppose as a number of chiral center, suppose only one chiral, according to as a Hund's of what we can call it as a Hund's of rule, that we will see later on. So Hund's of, according to as a Hund's of is a scientist name, he provided some of the derived some of the formulae. According to that, we are getting as a number of different structure. They suppose as a glyceraldehyde, it is one of the simplest carbohydrate, and there are 3 carbon atom, and that's why we can call it as a triose, because we are learning as a basics of carbohydrate. So there it is also termed as a triose. Tri indicate as a 3 carbon atom in the straight chain, and OSE indicate as a sugar unit present here. OSE is called as a sugar unit, or it is a sugar. So carbohydrates are naturally occurring organic compounds. Let us see the, we are talking about the introduction related to as a carbohydrates. So carbohydrates are naturally occurring organic compounds present in plants and animals. Look at, and therefore these words is very very essential or the prominent or what we can call it as the significant as far as this carbohydrate approach or the perspective is concerned, or we are talking about the different aspects of that carbohydrates and these carbohydrates, and from where this word is generated, origin of that carbohydrate, that type of the fundamental thing we are trying to learn at this discussion. So that carbohydrate are naturally occurring organic compounds present in plants and animals, right? And the name carbohydrate originated from the French hydrate of the carbon, or it is known as a hydrate, means that water of the carbon, hydrate of carbon. And every natural product which we eat contain carbohydrate in one or the other form, because whatever we are eating, and they are, some of them or one of them must be as a carbohydrate, means it is a major ingredient or the constituent present in our diet. And compounds like glucose, fructose, cane sugar, starch, cellulose, which are widely distributed in plants, are composed of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and belongs to the class of compounds called as the carbohydrates. This word we have here from it is originated, that we have seen carbohydrate are formed in green plants as a result of photosynthesis. And we know that photosynthesis, it is one of the unique property of the plants, and that photosynthesis, as we know that, which is the fixation of carbon dioxide and water by utilization of energy gained through absorption of visible light in presence of catalysts such as green coloring matter, is known as chlorophyll. And for example, suppose as a how this unique property or that photosynthesis, how it is carried out generally, that we are going to see over here. Suppose as the X number of carbon dioxide, as we know that carbon and dioxide plants, and then water, we can Y number of H2O, and we know that they are readily available in the atmosphere, and that here solar energy in the form of H2 is nothing but as a solar energy, and the catalyst used here is a chlorophyll, which is the green color of that plant is generally due to the chlorophyll, that is a chlorophyll that is used as a catalyst here. And as we know that the function of catalyst, it is a specific catalyst, and this reaction carried out under the sunlight in presence of chlorophyll, and what we are going to get generally, this produces that CX into H2O hydrate Y and plus X number of oxygen. And because that oxygen atom, and due to that we are inhaling oxygen atom due to the plant, and therefore plant is playing very prominent, very very important role in our day-to-day life. Without plant we cannot live on the earth, because they are supplying, they are producing, they are generating oxygen atom, and we are inhaling, and that's why we are living on the earth. Otherwise the animal cannot be present on the earth without the plant, and therefore plant is playing as a very prominent role in terms of this CXH2OY, it is just now we have seen as a carbohydrate. Carbohydrates are polyhydroxyaldehyde, are the ketone, optically active, and on hydrolysis producing as a this type of the thing is called as a carbohydrate. This is known as a carbohydrate. This is generated during the photosynthesis, and this process is known as a photosynthesis. This is a God gift we have got here, and that's why this is a carbon fixation of that carbon and the water molecule together under the sunlight in presence of the catalyst chlorophyll, and we are getting as a carbohydrate. And carbohydrate is a essential nutrient, or what we can call it as a gradient, ingredient present in our diet. So that carbohydrate, so how it is important, how it is formed naturally, where in a green plant we can get this type of the carbohydrates. And that carbohydrates are formed in green plants as a result of photosynthesis, which is the fixation of carbon dioxide and the water by utilization of energy gained through absorption of visible light in presence of catalyst such as green coloring matter, that is a chlorophyll, and we got that as a carbohydrate. And thousands of plus glucose molecule can be combined to form the much larger molecule of cellulose, which constitute the supporting framework of the plant. That is, a plus glucose molecule can also be combined in a somewhat different way to form the large molecules of starch, which is then stored in the seeds of serve as a food for a new growing plant. And when eaten by animal, the starch or cellulose are broken down into the original plus glucose unit, and these are carried by the blood stream to the liver by recombine into a glycogen or animal starch plus glucose is carried by the blood stream to the tissue, which it is oxidized and ultimately to carbon dioxide and the water, with the release of energy originally supplied as a sunlight. And therefore these carbohydrates, now whatever carbohydrates are there, the carbohydrate when eaten by that animal, or then what is going to happen, this CX, then here is a H2O Y. Why? This is a carbohydrate. This is a formula of carbohydrates, that is a polyhydroxy aldehyde or the ketone carbohydrate. When it is oxidized, the green plants are eaten by that animals, and what is happening there, or this under what we can call it as under carbohydrates, how solar energy, just now we have seen how it is taking place, then that will be plus X of, now oxygen atom is already present over there, then oxidize this in the form of tissue. And when these type of the reactions are taking place, after the oxidation, that carbohydrate again converted into as a glucose back. How this is generated again in the form of that carbon dioxide CO2, and as well as then what is producing over there further, that is a Y number of H2O, we are getting as a reverse of this whatever. And plus, in addition to that, carbohydrate after the oxidize in presence of the oxygen, it producing carbon dioxide as well as that water molecule, and the energy released during this process, and that energy is used as a source of what we can call it as, this carbohydrate is used as a source of energy and we are living here on the earth. And this some of the what we can call after this animal is eaten, that carbohydrate that producing as this type of the forms are after the oxidization, carbon dioxide is produced, water molecule and the energy is produced over there in this way. And some of this plus glucose is converted into fats. Some of that plus the glucose is converted into fats, and some reacts with nitrogen containing compound to form amino acid. And as we know that amino acid, there are the 20 amino acids are there. They are in the form of L configuration and alpha amino acid, and all are the naturally occurring amino acid. Out of 20, 19 amino acids are the chiral in nature, and only one glycine is a chiral in nature, and all are having as a L configuration, or we can call it as a L series of that, and which in turn combine to form the protein. And that amino acid, it is one of the monomer, or what we can call it, they are the building blocks of the protein. And most of the part of the what we can call protein that make up the large part of the animal body, which is present in our body, large number of the proteins are there. And thus plus glucose, cellulose, starch, glycogen, and all belong to class of organic compound known as carbohydrates. Look at this again as a carbohydrate means what? Thus plus glucose plus means as I already told you at the beginning while defining the definition of the carbohydrate. Carbohydrates are polyhydroxy, optically active aldehyde or the ketone. On hydrolysis they produce sugar unit is known as carbohydrates. So that is a definition of it. So thus plus glucose plus indicate as a dextrorotatory, means they are the optically active in nature, that is a experimental what we can call it as a experimental quantity of this physical property of that organic compound. The plus glucose, cellulose, starch and glycogen all belong to the class of organic compound known as a carbohydrates. And carbohydrate provide us the three basic needs of life, such as we know that man has three basic needs, or man's required three basic needs. And what are those, you might be knowing? And all those three basic needs man require, or man need three basic needs. One of them is a food, second one is a clothing, and third one is a shelter. So these are the three basic needs of every man, and therefore all these three basic needs are provided by carbohydrate, and therefore it is very very prominent as far as organic chemistry is concerned. And therefore they are providing three basic needs of life, such as food means from sugar and the starch, and from that we are getting as a everyday we are eating such type of the thing, and we without that we cannot live over there. And second one is a clothing, and from cellulose we are getting this cloth. Then shelter, that cellulose of wood we can made this. So all these three basic needs are fulfilled by this carbohydrate. And now let us look at some of the importance of carbohydrates. And in addition to these basic needs, there are some importance of carbohydrate form major constituent of diet and are widely used in manufacturing of articles of daily use like cotton fabrics, artificial silk, paper, plastics, films, nitrous fuses which are used in a explosion or explosives and other useful materials. So these are the general introduction regarding how it is essential, how it is important as far as mankind is concerned. And now let me tell you again the definition of that carbohydrate, and now the actual definition and the classification of carbohydrate, whatever we have seen regarding as a basics of carbohydrate. There we have learned, we have discussed the basics of carbohydrate in the introductory part. Now let us look at, here is a definition and classification. Definition and the classification, simply definition is a polyhydroxyaldehyde or ketone. Definition is a very simple, shortest definition of the carbohydrate, polyhydroxyaldehyde or polyhydroxyketone. The definition here, carbohydrates are polyhydroxy optically active polyhydroxy optically active aldehyde or ketones are known as carbohydrates. So that is the simplest definition of that carbohydrates, or it is sometimes referred as for example carbohydrates, like as a what we can call it as a this. Now let us move on to the classification, and this classification, carbohydrates are classified into three broad groups in accordance with their behavior on hydrolysis, and these are the classification of carbohydrates. Here how the carbohydrates are classified over there, let us see. On the basis of carbohydrate, it is mainly or broadly there are three types are there. Number one is called as a monosaccharides, number second is called as a oligosaccharide, number three is called as a polysaccharide. These are the three main types or the classification of that carbohydrates. Number one, we know that monosaccharide do not hydrolyze further into smaller units of the polyhydroxyaldehyde or the ketone. And second one is the oligosaccharide on hydrolysis yield 2 to 10 units of monosaccharide, and according to these they are further classified as disaccharide, trisaccharide and so on. And third one is a polysaccharide, and polysaccharide give a very large number of monosaccharides unit on complete hydrolysis, means carbohydrate that is a saccharide. And these saccharide sometimes it is written as a sugar unit, or saccharin means saccharide, is nothing but as a sugar unit, that's it. So let us see the classification of that carbohydrates. So let us see here, carbohydrates or saccharide, you can call it as a saccharides. And that saccharides, these carbohydrates, just now we have seen, it is further divided into broadly three types are there. Number one, number two and number three are there. Now let me draw properly over there so that we can see this, how the carbohydrates are classified. Let us see over here, classification of carbohydrate, or in bracket you can write as a saccharides. Saccharides, carbohydrates is nothing but called as the saccharides or the sugar unit, as we know that. And this is a further divided into three types. Number one is called as a Number first one is called as a monosaccharide, as we know that. Just now we have seen, mono means single, monosaccharides. Monosaccharides. So this is the name of first class of that monosaccharide. Number one is a monosaccharide. Second one is called as a oligosaccharide. Oligosaccharides. And last one, the third one is called as a polysaccharides. Poly means many. Polysaccharides. These are the three main type of the carbohydrates. There are three types of the carbohydrate. One is called as a monosaccharide. Second one is called as a oligosaccharide. Third one is called as a polysaccharide. This you can call it as the first one. This one you can call it as the second one. This one is the third one. Monosaccharide, because they are on the basis of hydrolysis. They are classified here. And as we know that on the hydrolysis of that simple chemical reactions, on hydrolysis, they are producing such type of the carbohydrate, like as a monosaccharide, oligosaccharides, and the polysaccharides. And that monosaccharide on hydrolysis, they do not further hydrolyze. Monosaccharide means they are the single unit. They do not hydrolyze into the smaller unit. Monosaccharide do not hydrolyze. Monosaccharide do not hydrolyze further into smaller units. This is the smallest unit of monosaccharide. Is the smallest unit. They do not further hydrolyze. So this is a main thing we can remember as far as monosaccharide is concerned. And that monosaccharide, example of that monosaccharides are, very good example of monosaccharide is glucose, fructose, ribose. These are the glucose, as we know that glucose, fructose, ribose. These are the example of monosaccharide. Number one is a glucose, then fructose, then ribose. And as we know that OSE is nothing but as a sugar unit. This one, remember OSE. While studying as a nomenclature system, we will see that also. But here, just remember, OSE means nothing but as a sugar unit. And these are glucose, fructose, ribose. These type of the things are called as a monosaccharide. And they are the single unit. They do not further hydrolyze. So remember this one. But here, oligo, second one, look at as a oligosaccharides. And oligosaccharide on hydrolysis yield 2 to 10 monosaccharide units. So this is a specialty of this yield. After the hydrolysis, yield 2 to 10 monosaccharide unit on hydrolysis. Yield means product. Here you can remember Y-E-I-L-D, yield 2 to 10 monosaccharide units. Monosaccharide units on hydrolysis. Remember, hydrolysis, it is a process very, very essential as far as the carbohydrate chemistry is concerned. Yield is nothing but as a product, or the resulting compound is known as a yield. Yield 2 to 10 monosaccharide unit on hydrolysis. Hydrolysis, it is one of the process that treated in presence of catalytic amount of acid, in presence of water, and that type of the process is known as hydrolysis. So yield 2 to 10 monosaccharide units on hydrolysis, and they are further divided into, these monosaccharide are further divided into three types. Number one is called as a disaccharide.
Number one is called as a disaccharides. And disaccharides, and that disaccharides are yield two monosaccharide unit on hydrolysis. These dyes clearly indicate as a two. Two is there. Disaccharide means yield, YIELD, yield two units of monosaccharides on hydrolysis. For example, the best example of that disaccharide is a sucrose. Sucrose is the best example of disaccharide, and after the hydrolysis of that sucrose, one glucose unit plus one fructose unit we are getting. Here the one glucose unit plus one fructose unit, and that is a sucrose, and therefore from sucrose we can prepare the sugar, we can derive the sugar. So sucrose is one of the disaccharide, and then after the on hydrolysis with dilute sulfuric acid or the dilute H2SO4 in sulfuric acid or hydrochloric acid, yielding one glucose unit and one fructose unit, so we can get this one. And after hydrolysis, and there is a separation because we are getting as a two unit, then one is a separation method is there on what we can call it as a, one is a soluble, that we will see later on, but here just remember two units are getting. Then another example is the maltose, and that maltose producing as a two units, one is a two glucose unit. So maltose which produce on hydrolysis gives the two glucose unit. And as we know that lactose is present in the milk, that is also as a one of the example of disaccharide, and from lactose we are getting one glucose unit as well as one galactose unit. So these are the two monosaccharide can be derived from that lactose which is present in the milk. As we know that lactometer, everything in dairy chemistry you might have heard about this. And now second one is called as a trisaccharides. Tri clearly indicate as there are three. Tri means trisaccharide, and that trisaccharide yield three monosaccharide unit on hydrolysis. That is the specialty of the trisaccharides. For example, raffinose trisaccharide on yields three units of monosaccharide on hydrolysis. So I am not writing this one, you can copy as it is, and here only I am giving as a example of that trisaccharide is a ribinose. Ribinose is one of the example of the trisaccharide, and on hydrolysis yielding three monosaccharide. One unit each of the glucose, fructose and the galactose. Is that structure after hydrolysis of that ribinose, one unit of glucose we are getting, one unit of fructose and one unit of galactose. These are the three units after hydrolysis we are getting. And the fourth one is known as a tetrasaccharides. This is the third classification of tetra, clearly indicate that on hydrolysis there are the four unit we are getting, and those four unit monosaccharide unit on hydrolysis, for example stichose, for example STY. Tie choice. Whatever pronouns you can pronounce is that is a tie choice is a example of tetrasaccharide on hydrolysis. It produces the 4 units, 1 unit of glucose, 1 unit of fructose, and 2 units of the galactose. These are producing over there, and as we know that this polysaccharide, example of polysaccharide, yield large number of monosaccharide unit on hydrolysis. Nearly 200 to 1000 type of the monosaccharides are obtained or produced from this polysaccharide, and the examples are starch, examples are starch, glycogen, cellulose. These are the example of polysaccharides. Starch, as we know that starch, then cellulose, and second one, and third one is glycogen. These are the three examples which clearly indicate as a polysaccharides. So in this way we have seen or we have learned the what are the introductory part as well as the definition and the classification of carbohydrate we have seen over here. So remaining basic carbohydrate we will see in the next lecture. Let us stop today here. Thank you. Have a nice day.